Welcome everyone. Welcome Nicola. I'm not going to mention about being slightly late. But also, I love how Nicola has swapped her flowers for her son. How very, very wonderful that is. And he's welcome to stay here. That's absolutely fine. As I said, I'm Lauren. I'm one of the clergy here in Andover Parish. It's a joy to be with you. I just want to invite you to take your seats as we begin our service. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you and also with you. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. God of wonder and joy, grace comes from you, and you alone are the source of life and love. Without you, we cannot please you. Without your love, our deeds are worth nothing. Send your Holy Spirit and pour into our hearts that most excellent gift of love, that we may worship you now with thankful hearts and serve you always with willing minds through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. You carry on, absolutely smashing it. Welcome. I would love to invite Christopher Garrity. I can't say your name, I don't know why, Garrity, to come up and read a poem, maybe.
We actually like it. I feel like it. Maybe. Maybe we are supposed to meet the wrong people before you arrive. So when they finally arrive, we are truly grateful for the gifts we have been given. Maybe it's true that we don't know what we have lost until we lose it, but it is also true that we don't know what we're missing until it arrives. Maybe the happiest of people don't have the best of everything, but make the best of everything that comes their way. Maybe the best kind of love is where you sit on the sofa together, not saying anything, not saying a word, and walk away feeling like it was the best conversation you've ever had. Maybe once in a lifetime, you find someone who not only touches your heart, but also your soul. Someone who loves you for who you are, and not what you can be. Maybe the art of love is not about finding the perfect person, but about seeing an imperfect person perfectly.
We're now going to stand as we celebrate this special day with this wonderful family. Please stand for our first hymn, Come to a Wedding.
Thank you.
invite you to take your seats, except you both. We're going to remind ourselves of why we are here. In the presence of God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we have come together to witness the marriage of Ricky and Nicola, to pray for God's blessing on them, to share their joy and to celebrate their love. Marriage is a gift of God in creation, through which husband and wife may know the grace of God. It is given that a man and woman grow together in love and trust. They shall be united with one another in heart, body, and mind. As Christ is united with his bride, the church, the gift of marriage brings husband and wife together in the delight and tenderness of sexual union and joyful commitment to the end of their lives. It is given as a foundation of family life in which children are nurtured and in which each member of the family, in good times and in bad, may find strength, companionship, and comfort, and grow to the maturity of love. Marriage is a way of life made holy by God, and blessed by the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ, with those celebrating a wedding at Cana in Galilee. Marriage is a sign of unity and loyalty, which all should uphold and honour. It enriches society and strengthens community. No one should enter into it lightly or selfishly, but reverently and responsibly in the sight of Almighty God. Ricky and Nicola are now to enter this way of life. They will each give their consent to one another and make solemn vows. And in token of this, they will each give and receive a ring. We pray with them that the Holy Spirit will guide and strengthen them, that they will be filled with God's purpose for the whole of their earthly lives together. We'll now get to the time of declarations. But before we do, just to make sure everybody knows, if you have children, and they want to wander around a little bit, or even be cuddled by the bride, that's absolutely fine. Please do not feel like you're doing any destructiveness. It's fine. We all want to scream out loud sometimes in the middle of service. It's fine. Keeps it spicy. Right. Now, I'm going to read the declarations, and there are going to be a moment where you get to join in. And I just want to encourage you, don't join in with a soft, boring, you know, we will. Join in with gusto, okay? I'll give you a hint, deep breath before you join in, that helps. First, I'm required to ask anyone present who knows the reason why these persons may not lawfully marry to declare it now. The vows you are about to take are to be made in the presence of God, who is the judge of all and knows all secrets of the heart.
You're right.
Therefore, if either of you knows any reason why you may not lawfully marry, you must declare it now. Ricky, will you take Nicola to be your wife? Will you love her, comfort her, honour and protect her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Nicola, will you take Ricky to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him, forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live?
I will.
It's going to be easier for him because he's got salt. That's very happened. And family and friends of Ricky and Nicholas, will you support them in their marriage now and in the years to come?
We will.
We will.
They will. That does mean babysitting any time they want you to. Just so you know. So and our prayer for this special day of awakening. God, our Father, from the beginning you have blessed creation with abundant life. Pour out your blessing upon Ricky, Nicola, Poppy, and Sebi, that they may be joined in mutual love and companionship, in holiness and commitment to each other. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You will be pleased to know that you now get to sit down, which those chairs over there are for you. Make sure you help me. Either one. Whichever one you get to go.
I'll go this way and see the children.
Wonderful. I'm now going to invite our first reading. You knew that.
The reading is headed, Getting a Perfect Relationship. As God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, meekness, and patience. Bear with one another, and if anyone has a complaint against another, forgive each other. Just as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Above all, clothe yourselves with love, which binds everything together in perfect harmony. And let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, to which indeed you are called in one body. And be thankful that the word of Christ dwell in you richly. Teach and admonish one another in all wisdom, and with gratitude in your hearts, sing psalms, hymns and spiritual songs to God. And whatever you do, in word or deed, do everything in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Wonderful, thank you. As we gather here to celebrate Ricky and Nicola, we're reminded of the profound message that Scripture has, taking Colossians 3, 12 to 17, which we just heard so beautifully read. This passage is full of love and full of the daily significance that marriage has in the lives of those who enter into it. This day has taken a lot of time to get it. A lot of time. The waiting has included some joy, some children, some challenges, often around the some worry. But the love that these two have has held fast. There's something quite wonderful about being able to preside over their wedding, as we see already the fruit of what they bring when they share life together. Paul, in his letter to Colossians, writes, therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. I have no doubt that they both believe with all of their hearts that they both wholeheartedly bring all of those qualities all of the time to their home. I'm going to celebrate my 17th wedding anniversary. Terrible business. And I would like to just say, patience does not run smoothly all the time. Certainly not a linear thing. Who else is married in the room? Anyone else? Great. Anyone else being married? Yeah. Got to treat everyone. Anyone else not want to? Not something that we just do. There's not that moment where you're on cloud nine, you just met that person, and you that infatuation that we have with someone at the beginning of a relationship is not what really does the job. What really does the job is daily choosing to lay our lives down and choose the other person. And that's not easy, it's not always glamorous, it's not always, you know, this wonderful paradigm experience. You know, some couples have flatulence at night time. In the morning, the last thing you want to do is choose to love them in some significant way. And yet we do. We go down, make a cup of tea, whatever your practice is, we choose in our little ways to stay, to commit, to be with them, to contend with them, to bear with them, and to love them. What a magnificent passage to be starting your adventure of marriage to. It reminds us of the importance of compassion. It reminds us of the importance of kindness and patience. It reminds us that our interactions with each other on a daily basis really matter. These qualities are a good and strong foundation for marriage. Paul continues to talk about this idea of bearing with each other and the forgiveness. And it's not just necessary, but commanded by Jesus. Every explanation and every description of love in this passage is intrinsically linked to the kind of love we experience and see from God Himself. We see in this passage that God is not talking about marriage as an abstract thing, or indeed just as a human thing, but as a prophetic thing, something that tells of a deeper truth. Marriage is not just a piece of paper that we sign. Marriage is a covenant promise that speaks of God's covenant promise, not just to us, but to Himself and the Trinity. When we enter into marriage, we are not just loving another person. We're not just loving the family that we may have. We are showing that God loves the world. That God has chosen to bear with us. That every day His mercy is new, even though we are only men. He still doesn't give up. He still turns up every day. The passage says, let the peace of Christ rule in your hearts, since as members of one body you are called to peace. Peace is a gift, and it comes from understanding, unity, and moreover, it comes from our relationship with Christ. Some of us might be sat in the room thinking, this whole thing that she's talking about with marriage being like this is impossible. That's not a thing that can happen. How can you love someone like that for your whole life? How can you do that? You can't, is the answer. I don't really think that we're able to. I think that the only way a human creature can love another human creature for its whole life is because God's love dwells in us. When anyone chooses to love someone else, he joins in when someone chooses to love someone else. Ricky and Nicola, I got to come to your house, and that was a joy. Absolute joy, not chaos. Just joy. I got to witness a really, cliffhanger moment where we all were waiting to see whether Sebi would sit down and eat his biscuit. Or not. And the biscuit at one point, it was soggy, wasn't it? Oh, who knew where it was going to go? On the sofa. Not on the sofa. But, you know, it was touch and go there for a moment. It was like an epic film. But it was a joy to sit with them. And we went through their journey so well. I felt at times that I was kind of on this roller coaster with them as they explained how time had unfolded for them since they met. Again, much of what we're talking about today, dwelling with each other, forgiving each other, bearing with each other, having a home that's full of compassion and love, having peace reign when everything is on fire, is something that these guys have already been practicing for some time. In conclusion, Paul writes, and whatever you do, whether in word and deed, do it in the name of the Lord Jesus. Give thanks to God the Father through Him. Ricky and Nicola, may you live out your marriage such a way that everything you say and do is a reflection of your love for one another and your gratitude to God for His love. And that includes your arguments. May you have conflict with each other. May you be honest with each other, even if that means the other one doesn't mind it. And may it always lead to peace in the end. As we witness this marriage today, let us remember the truth found in this passage. May Ricky and Nicola build a marriage filled with compassion and kindness, humility and gentleness, patience and above all love. May they know where all of those things actually come from, and never strive to try and get them to well up in themselves, but to look for the well that never runs out, God Himself. And may faith grow and be an anchor that guides them through all of life's joys and challenges. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, let us give thanks for the love that we see before us in this beautiful couple and their family. Amen. Before we get on to the good bit, we're going to stand and sing again. Wonderful. Why don't we stand together?
Thank you.
Now we get on to that wonderful part. And I know that later on you're going to go off and have a party. And it's going to involve lots of food, maybe some drinks, and you might forget what this was about. And I just want to remind you that in a moment we're going to do the bit that this was all about. And I hope that at some point this afternoon, when all the drinks are flowing, and are you having a disco?
Yeah.
And the disco is happening, and you're all embarrassing yourselves. At that point, I hope you remember this moment, because this is what we're doing today. So I invite you to face one another. Exchange a tissue. Now, face one another. Ricky and Nicola, I now invite you to join hands and make your vows in the presence of God and his people. So you repeat after me. I, Ricky Butcher.
I, Ricky Butcher.
Thank you. Nicola Garrity.
Take you, Nicola Garrity. You, Nicola Garrity.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish. Until death do us part. According to God's holy will. In the presence of God, make this vow.
Heavenly Father, by your blessing, let these rings be to Ricky and Nicola a symbol of unending love and faithfulness, to remind them of the vow and covenant which they make this day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. We will now get to the exchanging of the ring. We have got a stand-in, little stand-in ring today, but I'm going to bless the real one from soon. When it's ready. So, repeat after me. Nicola, I give you this ring.
Nicola, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
As a sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honour you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share.
And all that I have, I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
If you repeat after me, Ricky, I give you this ring.
Ricky, I give you this ring.
As a sign of our marriage.
Sign of our marriage.
With my body, I honor you.
With my body, I honor you.
All that I am, I give to you.
All that I am, I give to you.
And all that I have, I share with you.
And all that I have, I share with you. And all that I have I share with you.
Within the love of God.
Within the love of God.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen. Once it's on, you don't have to take it off ever. Alright, we happy? In the presence of God and before this congregation, Ricky and Nicola have given their consent and made their marriage vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, and therefore I proclaim them husband and wife. So this little bit we do now, this is where tying the knot comes from. So this is actually traditional liturgy of the Church of England, and this is tying the knot. We have to be together now for the rest. Where is it? Where is it? Across it. Those who God has joined together, let no one put asunder. There you go. You're done now. Right, what we're going to do now is we're going to bless the marriage. So I'm going to invite the couple and their children, if they want to, so we'll have to have a say in this, to come and kneel, and we're going to pray. So I'm going to pray for this wonderful family. If you want to join in, if you do not have to, you can put your hand out, just to make sure you feel like you're part of this, but we'd love to pray for you all. Blessed are you, Lord God, for you have created joy and happiness, pleasure and delight, love, peace and fellowship. Pour out the abundance of your blessing upon Ricky and Nicola, Poppy and Seth, in their lives together. Let their love for each other be a seal upon their hearts and a crown upon their heads. Bless them in their work and bless them in their companionship. Awake and sleep, in joy and sorrow, in love and in love. Give your mercy. Bring them to that banquet where your saints might feast forever in your heavenly home. We ask this through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you, now and forever. God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit, bless, preserve, and keep you. The Lord mercifully grant you the riches of his grace, that you may peace in both in body and soul, and living together in faith and love, may receive the blessing of eternal life. Amen. Amen. This is when we give another cheer.
Can't do that. No, we're through yet. Gentlemen, the King.
The King. The King. The King.
Sit down.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce my new father-in-law. Father of the bride is Pete Garrity. Toby, your request has been granted by the bride and groom, provided it is done in public in the middle of the dance floor. That's the proviso.
And what was his request?
His request was that he wanted to propose to his girlfriend. First of all, can I please reiterate our thanks for you coming to help Janet and I celebrate the marriage of our loving daughters. Especially those that have travelled, and a deep gratitude and thanks to those family friends who have supplied support, resources, and more importantly, time to make this special day possible. So, for all of them, can we just have a quick round of applause? Also, you will notice that there is a blank there for absent friends. Our thoughts are with those, especially my father, who Nicki had a very close relationship. She had a very close relationship with him, and he was the only person she was the only person he would listen to and act on her advice. Also, one I will mention is Jill's husband Andy, who is also a friend. And of course, all the others are thoughts are totally with them. Right. Now, that today is another great big tick in my bucket list. Now, immediately you're thinking, I've got rid of her. Thank you. Totally wrong. Since the day my daughter Nicki was born, I find this very difficult. Since the day she was born, I have waited and looked for the time I could escort her baby up. Well, I wasn't going to say that, but yeah, you're right.
Sorry, Pete, can we record that?
And I'm so pleased, or we are so pleased, that, you know, what I dreamed for came true. She looked absolutely stunning, so very beautiful, in a wedding dress. So, I'm, you know, it's a very emotional day. A very emotional time for both Dana and I. Now, some of you, or many of you will know, that while she was growing up, her and I had a rather tempestuous relationship. That could be an understatement. But all I will say is, thankfully, Jan was there as both referee and peacemaker. However, I wish there was an ombudsman so I could complain because all the blame decisions went wrong. But now she's grown up, all I have is an enormous great love and affection for her. She's a fantastic person. Mind you, I should add to that, how can I not love someone who has the same fine qualities as me? Stubbornness, single-mindedness, logic, to name but a few. However, she also has a plethora of Jan's and those of compassion and caring. So now, as an adult, she's a very rounded, balanced person. Well, I must add that when I read all this stuff about Rankin's speech online, it said be kind to the bride, so I thought I'd better be.
Don't go over the top.
Yeah. So, I'm just trying to catch it with her. Yeah. So, there. But, yeah. So overall, Nicola's a very balanced person.
Come on, Rory, get it right.
I know. I'm going to have to read here a bit, yeah?
Yeah.
Can face virtually anything with equanimity. And I think that's true. Occasionally stroppy. Occasionally angry. Used with artistic license. Yeah? But with a heart of gold who will do anything for anybody at any time. So I think, she deserves a round of applause. However, I would carry on to say that her determination is not something new. As a three-year-old, Nicola decided she did not like being told no. Oh, I told you I haven't changed. So, she decided, she opened the door, announced she was leaving, and went out. Don't worry, I said to Jan, she won't be long. Not Nicola, though. I had to chase her down the street and drag her back, kicking and screaming home, probably. Eh? So, yes, she's still got that determination. Yeah? That determination has been pushed very hard recently with both her children, with the medical problems they have. And we are both, Nicola and I, so, so proud of her. The fact that she has managed to get all the things done that she's got done. With Poppy, with her, you know,
and Sarah,
with his heart problems. Absolutely fantastic. Yeah?
Brilliant.
However, it also reminds me of a very young girl who, with Resolve, faced multiple operations on her ears. So she's been the same all her life. So I'm surprised about it. Let me go there. Moving on, I'd like to have a picture of Brecon Beacons. Middle of the night, pitch black. Five people, two adults, Andrew, Jill's late husband, and me, three children, Martin, Nick, and Nicola, lost. Andy's, I'm going to say what to say, Andy's directional skills had left him. And then, to make it worse, Nicola slipped over. Hurt her ankle.
Down a hole.
Was it?
Yeah.
Okay, you fell down a hole. You just ruined the next big couple. So there we are, dark, carrying Martin and Nick. Obviously not the size they can do right now. In fact, now they'll be carrying us. And Nicola having to walk, and all done without a single moan or a single complaint. Fast forward a few years, Yorkshire three-peat. She did the same thing. Slipped over, injured her ankle, but this time walked so flipping far away that when she got to the point where the doctor just said, you ain't going any further. Right? And it nearly ended up with serious problems with her ankle. The worst bit was, though, Jan had to drive up there to bring her back. Right? Yeah. The thing is though, what Nicola is showing is also very evident in both Poppy and Sebastian. So all I can say is, Ricky, I am feeling very sorry for you. Already. Horses. She was and still is mad on horses. At the riding school, her favourite horse was Amber. A horse with exactly the same personal traits as Nicola. So despite pleas from the staff that this horse was not suitable for her, Nicola really was adamant that these are her horse. So that explains Nicola's bad back, poor ankles, the fact that Amber would refuse to do certain procedures, rubber against the fence. And in fact, at the stage where Janet wouldn't actually take her riding because she was afraid to watch this battle of wheels. Yeah. So try and summarise then, from the toddler whose most favourite word was why, and try not answering that, Nicola, and you don't work. Yeah? To the schoolgirl who didn't want to be a sheep. To the fantastic, loving, caring, compassionate mother she is now. And we hope, Jan and I both hope, that this has given her virtually everything she wanted. A lottery might be the icing on the cake, but who's that not for anybody here? Right, Ricky.
Hello.
My new son Ricky,
come here.
Christmas. Can I formally welcome him to the family?
No.
Sorry, we haven't had a full family vote on this yet.
Much as I might like to say that, I can't say it today. It's rather debated anyway, if you know him. However, I will say that when we first met him, he was obviously the right choice for Nicola. He gave as good as he got. So therefore, a pretty good match. Albeit, perhaps a bit tiresome. I don't know if that's such a word, but what? He's seen the worst and the best of us over the years he's been with us. But he's still here. So it must show a certain resolve and determination. So, Ricky, keep up that determination and resolve, because we do not accept returns, and there are definitely no refunds. The stuff of the speech says I should give advice. What advice can I give to a couple that have lived together for 7 years and produced two fantastic children? How about some of the things it's taken me probably nearly half a century to learn? Marriage is not a competition, it's cooperation. Communicate openly, honestly, and freely on anything and everything. That's pushing. But crucially, laugh a lot. And try to follow the philosophies in the poem Desiderata and the lyrics of Sanskrit. Now that's going to have you all searching Google shortly, isn't it? Not at the moment.
Well, I've been early on, but no.
Now, the most important advice I'm going to give: do not let Nicola watch the carpenter's store. Especially on New Year's Eve. As she has a habit of tipping chairs over and smashing the teeth.
And breaking the shoulder.
Breaking my arm.
The trouble is, I'm pretty sure it's genetic, because Poppy seems to think that chairs are better on two legs rather than four.
And what is two legs
though? The ones at the back. Well, and I'm not going to sneak on Poppy by saying fortunately she hasn't injured herself yet. Right, now I'm supposed to finish with a toast. So please do be outstanding. And Ricky and Ricky, may you both completely fulfil those dreams and fantasies throughout the rest of your lives. We all wish you hakuna matata. You'll have to ask the children what that means if you don't know. And I need to be just big. And have a long, peaceful, and prosperous marriage. To Ricky and Nicki.
Thank you there to to my dad. He managed to make it through without faltering too much. I'm going to try and do the same myself, but I can't guarantee it. Right, before I start, we have been given some advice about public speaking. So, Nicki, I'm imagining you naked. Just, you know, we did have a singer booked to come this evening, so we like a jazz singer was supposed to be singing through the first, through the meal. Unfortunately, she's pregnant during January, and she recently fainted whilst performing. So she was generous enough to let us have some music, so for the first like 10 or 11 tracks that you heard this evening, that was her singing. So just to involve her in the wedding, let's have some music, which was quite nice of her. So ladies and gents, I'm going to try not to take up too much of your time, but there are a few things that bride and groom should say and share on their big day. So, you're ready for it. After 7 years to the day of waiting since you're proposed, on behalf of my wife and I, thanks, Dave. Here we go. We would both like to thank everyone for coming today. It means a lot to us both to have all of our family and friends here with us on our special day. We really do appreciate the effort everyone has made, so thank you for that. And a personal cheers.
Can I drink the water?
For those of you who did the readings this afternoon in the church, I'd like to thank my brother-in-law, Christopher. Good sight. My godmother, also my aunt, Auntie Liz. And she's not listening, she's out of the room. However, I think everyone will agree that Poppy absolutely.
I'm
used to being ignored by my children and my wife now, so it's not something I've grown very used to. Yeah, she absolutely smashed it. I got emotional when Nicki walked in, but when Poppy started reading that way, I probably knew from either.
You were in front of
me. I don't think they're watching me. Anyway, so I'll go on, otherwise we'll get kicked out.
Are you any out of my life?
To my mum. I'm pretty sure everyone in this room would like to thank you for producing an incredible son.
Which one?
Two sons.
We do have work about that.
Two sons. However, I do want to thank you for all the support you've given me with everything that we've gone through, or everything we've gone through, before and after I'm Nicki. Admittedly, waiting until I was in the Falklands to sell the house didn't help. But as today has proved, we can all move on with our lives to say thank you for helping to make me the man I am.
Pleasure.
So, to my mum. So, Jan and Pete, my new mother and father-in-law. Thank you for always making me feel welcome within your family, and I hope I can live up to your expectations you have for a husband to your daughter. And Pete, thanks for very willingly giving Nicki away. When I asked if I could have her hand, or your daughter's hand in marriage, I've never heard anyone say yes so quickly. I will point out, though, that you haven't really got rid of her, as we'll always come around for homemade pizzas. And Gaz can now vouch for the cheesy goodness. And I'll even go as far as to say that they're better than your chili. Ooh. That's a personal opinion, so I can't say that. I was slightly concerned this morning when I checked my emails, and there was an email from Microsoft telling me that I'd been removed from the family group.
I'll tell you what's
happening. I've checked his emails.
What? Quiet, Dave. On a serious note, though, we would both like to thank you both for everything you've done to make this day happen. Without your help and deep pockets, that's been really powerful and possible. So thank you to the Martin Fire Group for it. Sorry, this is me drinking to you, and also to get me more drunk. To the Guard of Honour, thank you for helping make the service and the day run so smoothly despite the weather, and doubling up to my ushers last minute, surprise. You definitely did some good ushering. I couldn't see the swords on the way when Nicki came in, however, looked spot on. I was going to say something about training, and in fact I was there to help you, but I just abandoned and let you do it, but I think you might. Seriously, Mark has already said that the photos are going to look amazing, so I'll make sure that you'll get to see them and get copies as required. And thank you for helping with this evening report, etc. To our best man, I just want to thank Gaz for always being there whenever I need him. And you have supported me prior to meeting Nicki, and welcomed him into your life as much as you did with me. I think it may have been jealousy, but I'm sorry, Gaz, you're just not. To be fair, we did have an agreement that Nicki was like more than 45 minutes late. I was marrying Gaz, so I was very relieved. I was getting worried. Anyway, what I say he's good at supporting, he's not the easiest man to get a hold of. Since retiring from the RAF early this year, he sold his car and is now living the high life, living on a narrowboat. Which does make contact quite difficult sometimes, because there's never a signal. Near canals, and he never answers his phone anyway, because he's too busy chugging one. He's also travelling northwards, so has been pooling away from us, seeming less usual. Also, unfortunately, you can't claim rail miles like you can air miles, apparently, because otherwise you'd put in some serious travelling time and you'd be getting a new car, you might as well go off the rail. So, thank you, Gaz, for having done the work. So, the bridesmaids, flower girls, and page boys, you all look fantastic. Unfortunately, some of them are all up there, all in. Vomit all over the floor, it's not a problem. They did an amazing job walking up the aisle. I imagine I couldn't see it, but I'm sure everyone here would. They walked up the aisle really well. Also to Angela, I'm sure you agree, particularly Sam, her husband, that she looks amazing today. It's like disconcerting that her daughter laughs at that comment. She's done an amazing job of keeping Nicki calm, and I was going to say, actually helped to make it sound on time for once, however...
On a relative scale for
on the
life.
Grand scheme of things, being 20 minutes late wasn't actually that bad.
I thought we did really good. 15,
it was only 15.
Thank you very much for all the support you've given to Nicki throughout the years of known her, since Bottom Record, etc. And thank you for helping my nervous wife. On her. So thank you. So, talking of my wife, as I am doing, I'm sure everyone will agree that you look absolutely stunning.
Woo!
Yeah! And I feel privileged that you said yes. Although I don't blame you, it was a very romantic proposal. I gatecrashed a baby shower 2 weeks before popping was due. Pop the question, the ring didn't fit because your fingers were swollen, and then I'm probably off out for a curry with your dad, Martin and Nick. I think that is the perfect proposal. Yes, once an Indian, I'm okay. If you are wondering why we chose today as the date for the wedding, as I said at the start of speech, it's actually exactly 7 years to the day that I proposed to Nicki. Some people say you have a 7-year itch, but I've sort of worked backwards. Instead of being 7 years to find something new, I've married a lovely man. So I was browsing the internet today for other slightly less important events, and I discovered the following. So in 1805, is the Battle of Trafalgar, where Lord Nelson defeated the French and the Spanish. Hurrah! In 1854, Florence Nightingale and staff of 38 nurses were sent to the Crimean War. Who knew? And in 1879, Thomas Edison applied for his patent design for an incandescent light bulb. More interestingly though, the 21st of October is the date that Martin McFly traveled forward to the Future Trilogy. Although he traveled in 2015, so how old does everyone in here feel right now?
Thanks for trying to find a hoverboard.
It's ridiculous. Now, Nicki, I did warn you that today was the one time that I have to tell you how I feel, and you have to sit there and take it. She doesn't like compliments, she doesn't like any affection, however. So here you go. Today, I am so happy that I get to marry my best friend. We have had a very stressful relationship, with the health issues that we touched on with children, but I can't wait to make many great memories with you in the future. Behind the birth of Poppy and Seth, today is the best day of our life. Let's just hope it doesn't go back to old from
tomorrow.
Oopsie.
Touch me, you got it. Right. I love you with all of my heart. You are an amazing aunt to the children. We may not have had the opportunity to share many of our firsts together, but I promise you that I will always try my best to make sure that I will know your grandma. So, anyway, it's now with a heavy heart. In fact, before I do that, Stephanie, to the bride, ladies and gentlemen.
To the bride.
To my wife.
You lucky talent, sir.
Right. This is now the awkward bit. It is with a heavy heart that I now have to hand you over to my best man. I have to warn you, Gaz is going to have to make up and tell up, or sorry, he's going to have to tell all sorts of stories that he's had to make up because we are so pure, he's got nothing on us. So please take everything with a pinch of salt, except he's saying something nice. But before I hand over, we would both again like to thank you for coming, and we all hope you have a fantastic rest of the evening. So from myself and Nicki, thank you, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you. Yeah. Right.
Are you coming over here?
I'm just going to stand here. There's a reason for this.
Okay,
so firstly, thank you to the room for that lovely speech and for making me start it with slightly red eyes now because you sent me off. Right, so before I actually start the speech, there is a tradition amongst the military people that should you leave your place name holder, your napkin holder, anything with your name on unattended, it can be taken and it can have things written on it.
Do you like this one here, guys? It's got my name on it.
Yes. Thankfully, I've already made notes of it.
Well, it doesn't matter what it
is. So, firstly, Dave.
Stand up.
Stand up. It just says on here, if possible, sir, I would like to make a speech too.
That's what you stood up. Thanks, everyone here. It's a love and honour. Can't do it any other way.
Stuart. Yeah. It just says, I shout a lot, but basically I'm pretty useless.
I'm pretty and useless.
And although it was stolen from me, I do remember contents of one that came from somebody
you dropped on the floor.
Somebody called Ricky, which says that he was so pleased with the work the Garda of Honour did that he'd like to pay for their drinks for the rest of the night. And he's also
I volunteered to do a full airfield inspection on foot in the rain to make up for what he put his guard bonnet through.
Fine man!
For those of you who are lucky enough not to know me, I'm Gaz, and as Rick has finally admitted, I'm the best man. I was currently an RAF air traffic controller alongside him in two tours, in fact.
You followed me?
I did. I've known him since he arrived at RAF Odeon back in 2010 as a new and thus useless air traffic controller.
Put yourself down.
We need a lot of training to be useful as air traffic controllers every time we arrive at new units. So after all these years and several controlling tours, he's no longer new, and he's in fact highly trained.
Apparently so. I don't think it's possible for either.
Unfortunately, he then got his commission, so he's gone back to being useless. Anyway, but going back to when I first saw him in the sergeant's mess bar, I thought, finally, a decent bit of eye candy around here. But it turned out that despite my best attempts, he just wasn't interested. I got him drunk. I begged. Please. Nothing. So, how sell for being his friend? And to help confirm our friendship, he actually attempted to marry me with the aid of a ballistic cat. I don't know if you've ever helped someone retrieve an angry cat from the top of a tree that it can't get out of, but it basically involved Ricky climbing all the way to the top of the tree.
We are talking the height of a house.
Yeah, we are talking a tall window. Three-story unit. It was above that. The cat was a long way up, it wouldn't come down, so we had to go up and get it. And I was down below, cleverly with a cat basket, pushing in it to catch the cat on the way down. Unfortunately, the terrified cat that Mickey was going to be picking up turned into an angry, spitting ball of claws and teeth, which was then launched at me at high speed. At this point, I panicked, went, put the cat basket over my head. Cat hit basket hit head, cat bounced out and ran away.
Not up the tree.
But not back up the tree, thankfully. However, how can you not be with friends with somebody who's just loved a mad cat? Proper bonding experience, I'd call it. Anyway, back to life and the mess. We were friends drinking together for a good couple of years. We talked through life's issues. We both have them, everyone has them. And, you know, I thought, I've still got time to work on it, maybe. My chances of actually pulling in were finally shot down in flames when he had the audacity to fall hook, line and sinker for Nicki. I wanted to be a jealous love rival, but she's actually far too lovely for that. I did have one chance today, though, because of our agreement. she had the nerve to show up.
Thank you, Angela.
Okay, so those things ruined. I'm going to have to move on, aren't I? Of course, with friends, I really, really loved coming to see both of you and the children. I was really honoured when I was asked to be godfather for the children. And I will always welcome you on the boat, and I will always be happy to come and visit you, no matter how complex it is to be, wherever I happen to be. I walked miles with heavy bags, got on trains with, I don't know if you've met the general public, but I managed to get a journey down actually this time with somebody who was eating trail mix, one by one, from a large sack on the table in front of him, and every single time was...
Thanks, guys.
Hours on end it went on for. Anyway, but it was still worth it because I got to come and see you. Anyway, I owe Ricky a favour, so can I ask you just to put your right hand on the table, please, just there. And Ricky, can I ask you to put your left hand on top? Okay, as promised, you've for one and only time got the upper hand in this relationship. Okay, I'm not walking on, so all I'm going to say is it's been an amazing day. I can't believe the amount of work you and everyone has put into it. It's been absolutely fantastic. And so I think, excuse me, I will finish there with a toast to the bride and groom.
Bride
and
groom. Bride and groom.
Bride and groom. Bride and groom.
Bride and groom. Bride and groom. Bride and groom.
Most of you guys don't know me, but I like to write your poetry every now and then, so I've written you guys a poem. I hope you like it. But before I start my poem, I've added another rhyme. I can't believe that Nicki got to the church on time.
Sorry.
You're married to her, not Gaz. So. Nicki and Ricky have become man and wife, and are now joined together for the rest of their life. They met back in December 2013, and what a roller coaster things since then have been. In Starbucks, the pair have their first date, and pretty highly they give each other rent. With trips to London and running the mess bar, the love grew even with Ricky being posted off the bar. On this very day, 7 years ago, was when Ricky got down on my knee, very, very low. Nicki said yes, and they planned to wed and started their journey to their marriage bed. Poppy came along bringing lots of ups and downs, smiles of happiness, and a few sad frowns. But time moved on, and now they own their own home, a place to make their mark on and become their very own. COVID was a nuisance, causing Ricky to stay away. But it meant he became an officer. Hip hip hooray! Next up, Severide, bringing with him challenges new. But look at him now, having just turned two. And he's just had a poo. At last, the day has come when two become one, and with it there'll be lots more craziness and fun. The children all look lovely, and radiant is Nicki, and the smartest chap in the room has to be Ricky. Let's all raise a glass as we stand and sit around the room. Congratulations to the bride and groom.
Jumping around or running around, please. Thank you.
It's just that the floor's vibrating. Okay, we're good.
Toby, stand to the side.
No, it's a universal truth. People let me down. So reach out for the things that you can do. Buried in the ground. I think I've been misunderstood. Not all my choices have been good. In the fading light. So we should put this one to bed before it bursts out of my head. Ready for the fight. It's too late, and I find my place. Who will save his soul? of another tiny life, full of big ideas. It strikes me, with the baggage left behind, I could dry those tears. All of my secrets, they are free. Now watch them tumble out of me into better days. So save those homiletic tones and conjure singing from the moans, and you'll hear me say, when it gets too late,
hey, hey, hey.